Suppose you increase this to some 5 newtons. Then also there is no motion. Again I can say the same thing. Then what should be F? This is also, this is friction. As there is no motion, agreed? Similarly, again there is no motion. Follow this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now it is gradually increased like this. You increase this further. Motion just begins means still it just begins to move. Understood this? So in that case, so now you can see there is still no acceleration. Any doubt is there?
No, sir.
Now you further. After this, the body continues to move. Suppose it's the acceleration. So by Newton's law, what is that you will get?
Yes, sir.
Till here, observe this carefully. This is only one chapter, this observation. Any doubts are there till here?
No, sir.
No, sir.
People have missed today's class, they can forget about friction chapter. So till here you followed, because they won't understand anything.
Followed, sir.
Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir.
Completed when?
1 minute, sir.
Hello, completed?
Yes, sir.
Then why you are not telling me?
Sir, I said before only.
Right. Now you observe this. There is no motion, no motion. Okay, there is not moving. Here also there is no motion. Strictly speaking, is there any motion? Just begins.
Yes, sir.
So here, the frictional force that is acting when there is no motion between two surfaces is called as static frictional force. Understood this? Static means there is no motion. And when there is motion you have, no, this is what you call it as kinetic frictional force. Understood this? Now in this you can see the static frictional force is having adjustable values. Its values are always equal to what external force applied, no? As long as there is no motion, force of static friction is equal to external force tending to cause motion. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
As you go on increasing the applied force to cause motion, at one stage, motion just begins. Among all the static force of frictional forces, which is the highest one? This one only, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is called the maximum force of static friction. It's all called, this is what you call as limiting friction. Remember, in all friction problems, you have to check what type of friction is acting. Is it static friction? Is it kinetic friction? Or is it limiting friction? If it is static friction, there is no motion. If it is limiting friction, motion just begins. If it is kinetic friction, there is motion. Understood this simple thing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No doubt.
Done, sir.
Can I turn this?
Yes, sir.
One minute.
Hello, go ahead. Right.
Yes, sir.
1 second. See here, motion impending means it is just beginning. That is the meaning. Impending means just begins, no? Right. See here, what you have learnt is friction has no motion. This implies that agreed. Follow this.
Yes, sir.
Now you can see when this changes, this also.
Yes.
Agreed. So whenever there is a motion, this is a situation. So can I conclude that force of static friction is a variable one or a constant one? Is a self-adjusting force. It adjusts. Understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then, what is the next stage we have, ma'am? Motion begins. This is all called as impense. That is, see, at this stage, how much is this? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now you have the frictional force. This is nothing but okay. The value of maximum static force of friction. What is that called? Do you agree with this? That means the body, the contact forces or the intermolecular forces will try to oppose the pulling force so that the intermolecular distance is not changing. Understood this? Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
At one stage, what happens is the intermolecular forces are not enough for the external pulling force. So in that case, what will happen? The body will be set into motion. Now you can see, when you keep a body, suppose you are pasting two bodies with some gum like araldite, will the bodies get attached or pasted better if you hold them together or you move one on the other?
Hold them together.
That means whenever there is a relative motion, they won't be bonding, bond won't be stronger, because the molecules are in continuously motion. Now, suppose this body is there, these molecules and these molecules, unless and until they give some time, they cannot get bonded. But you are moving. So what happens? This will go away from this. It will come in touch with another one. The body is here. Now it comes in touch with this. That means it won't have any permanent bonding with any molecule. That means the contact forces will become weak. Understood this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So that means we can say force of friction is lesser when there is motion. Then after that, what is the next one? Motion exists. That means here force of friction is
kinetic.
Understood this? So this kinetic frictional force Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Shall I turn this?
1 minute. 1 minute.
Hello? Shall I turn this?
1 minute.
See, I am trying to understand this concept. Whole chapter is only this one. Nothing else is there. Again, don't confuse yourself and purchase troubles. Can I turn this?
1 minute.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
1 minute.
Can you turn this?
Yes, sir.
So before the start of the problem, you should decide what is happening. Is motion existing, impending, or there is no motion? Accordingly, you should take the force of friction values. Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, we just review what we have learned. See, this is one block. We are applying a force F1. So, force of friction equals F1 when there is no motion. Again, you increase this. Again, there is no motion. So, this is the force of friction. Again, you increase this. Suppose there is no motion. Understood this? Now, say at some stage, motion impends. Impending means just begins. Then what you have? Okay, so this is the maximum value. Understood this? Now, if the same force continues, okay, now what will happen if the same force continues? This frictional force will now become what? Kinetic friction. What is this?
Kinetic friction.
This is static. This is static. This is static. This is also static but maximum value. Understood what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
So now what happens? As a kinetic friction is less than maximum value of static friction. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Clear? And what is F4? Previously you got this one, you know. Therefore, kinetic friction will be less than F4. So what will happen? F4 is more than kinetic. So what will happen? Therefore, body accelerates. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, we have F kinetic is mass of the body into acceleration. Understood this? Clear? Now, following or not?
Yes, sir.
Now you reduce the external force. You bring it to this. Okay. Say this F4 is now less than F4. For example. Understood? So we can say that either there is a stage that then what happens? So here you can see body
sir, can you move the pencil a little left first?
Understood this?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Understood. And suppose next stage, she tried to understand this. Now, the last one, suppose there is no external force. There is no force. And because it is in motion, so what will happen? There is an opposing force. What is that? Kinetic friction, no? So here you can see body retards. Understood this?
Yes,
is it clear?
Yes.
See, that is the reason why actually when you slide a body, say ball is, you are throwing on the ground. Actually, it should continue forever, it should move. But why it is stopping? Because there should be some force between the ball and the surface. Nobody is applying, it comes to rest. That means that is nothing but force of friction. Yes, you understood all this story?
Yes, sir.
Then you will be an expert in friction. Only this thing you should know. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And definitely, chapters. Friction chapter, if you miss this, it will be difficult. Can I turn this?
1 minute.
1 minute. 1 minute.
Completed, sir.
1 minute, sir.
Will you continue?
Just a minute, sir.
Can you turn this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, the chemical bonding nature depends upon the surfaces, no? For example, you keep oil on ground and you try to throw an object, that object takes longer time to come to rest. Do you agree? Suppose the surface is not smooth, it is very rough. Can the body move, slide for longer time?
No, sir.
That means it depends upon the nature of the surfaces. That means if they are highly polished or normal by the nature it is. And also on the materials of the surfaces. For example, chemical bonding between cement and wood will be different. And wood and rubber will be different. Agreed? See, for example, when your wife do wear shoes to reduce friction to some extent, no. You can walk faster. Did you ever observe? Clear or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that means we have, if you try to plot a graph, this is the external force. Tending to cause motion. This is force of friction. Okay, if you take like this, as long as there is no motion. Okay, so here, from here to here, what friction is acting?
Static friction.
So this part I can say this is nothing but force of static friction is acting. Understood? You can see that force of static friction equals to F. That means Y equals F, X only, no? So what is the slope? So what is the slope?
1.
That means tan theta is 1. Theta is 45 degrees. Follow this clearly?
Yes.
That means this must be 45 degrees. Agreed?
Yes.
Any doubt is that till here?
No.
Now this value, what you have is maximum value. Okay, that is nothing but of what? Static friction. What is that value called? That's also called as limiting friction. Understood this? After this, we have seen that this frictional force will slightly decrease. You have seen that now? Observe that carefully. In the end, what we have seen? Kinetic friction will come into role now, that will decrease and at once motion is there. See? Okay, so therefore it slightly decreases here. After that it goes like this. Almost a straight line. Okay, so this is nothing but so this point is what we call it as. Understood these 3 points? Hello?
Yes,
sir. Any doubt? Shall I turn this? Now, if you observe carefully, force of kinetic friction. Is less than force of limiting, which is nothing but maximum value of static friction. No? If you see that graph, force of kinetic friction can be greater than limiting. Can be greater than this? No, check up this. Okay. Agreed.
Yes, sir.
There are lesser than this now. From here to here, all these are static values only. So kinetic friction is more than that now.
Yes, sir.
Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, force of kinetic friction Do you agree with this? Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt, sir.
It may be less than, equal to, or greater than static friction. Understood this?
Yes, sir.
These points give you an idea. Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir.
1 minute.
Any doubts are there?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt.
Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir.
Return this.
Yes,
hello.
Sir.
When you complete, tell men, I'll be waiting. No, right. Come back to this. It's a common experience. Whenever you try to attach a paste, one body to the other, say for example, with gum or araldite, you will be hitting like this, or you are pressing the body. You remember? Hello?
Yes, sir.
When you are pasting two bodies, what you will press the bodies or will push the bodies?
Press the bodies.
You will try to press. That means you try to bring the body such that one will press more than the other, towards the other. Okay, by pressing, what is changing? When a pressing thing will come, whenever two contact forces are pressed, one force will come. What will happen? What is that force?
Normal
reaction. That means whenever normal reaction is more, bonding will be more. Agreed? That means contact force will be more. That means normal reaction will be more. So I can say that force of friction must be proportional to what? Normal reaction. Do you agree with this? More the normal reaction, more the force of friction. Do you agree with this or not? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes,
now
sir.
You can see which friction will be this. Is it limiting or static or kinetic?
Static.
Definitely this could not be static. No, static frictional force will be equal to applied force only, no? So this should be from limiting to kinetic, no?
Yes, sir.
So this should be what? I can say that force of friction. I will say that limiting. Or force of kinetic friction is also proposed to normal reaction. Why? Because for static friction less than limiting, what we have? Fs equals what? External force, no? Okay, it's a variable force. Do you agree with this? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Understood this or not?
Sir, understood.
That means I can say F limiting is proposed to normal reaction. So this means F limiting is equal to some constant of proportionality into normal reaction. That constant of proportionality is what you call it as mu s. Okay, mu s is coefficient of static friction. Similarly, here kinetic friction is proposed to normal reaction. Kinetic friction is some constant into normal reaction. This is mu k into n. Mu k is called coefficient of what? Which friction? Understood this? Any doubt is that till here?
No doubt.
Finish physics theory. One chapter is over. This theory. Now only numericals will do. The more the problems we do, the better your knowledge. Understood this?
Same question, sir. What, sir? Friction is also included.
No, not included. Before this, what all is complete? Constraints, strings, springs, wedge constraints.
Yes, sir.
What will prepare in this? Nothing. Efficiency will not come one day, no? Like you eat total eggs, biryani, everything in 1 hour, you'll get immunity by evening. Immunity is a process which will be developed throughout your lifespan. Food habits, everything together should be taken care of. Now many idiots after this corona has come, they are trying to increase immunity in one day, eating that food, this food. So here also your skills will develop over a period of time. One day I'll sit for 10 hours, I'll get physics, means you'll never learn. Shall I turn this? Completed?
Yes,
now you have seen that force of static friction is less than the maximum force. That means this implies force of this is less than limiting. Do you agree with this? That means this implies Fs is less than mu s n. Do you agree with this or not? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I can say that from all this, as F limiting is also it is a value of what? Do you agree with this? Any doubt is that till here?
No doubt, sir.
Therefore, I can say that static frictional force. Is less than equal to mu s n. Can I write like this? Clear?
Yes, sir.
So I'll say that understood this? Understood all this?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear or not? He returned this?
1 minute, sir.
1 minute.
Fast. You have any IP exams, huh? No, no.
No, sir.
For KL40, not KL40.
No, I only asked ourselves not to conduct all these dirty exams for GL, L40 students, either SL40 or GL40.
Are giving 1 week holiday for these exams.
That is BIPC, the dose, sir. He doesn't know anything and he won't listen also. You know he is very aged now, remember?
Yes, sir.
61 years or so. 62 or something, higher age only. So, he won't. And I don't generally enter into BIPC stream. I don't feel like that is it. The physics for them is very simple, no? This much analysis is not required. And last year, AIMS batch, all my students, they got 99%, almost all. Whole aim section. Physics is very easy for them. Shall I turn this?
Sir,
1 minute, 1 minute.
Because that is easy, they give 10 days, holidays, 1 week, or I don't bother. Why should I bother? For you people, means a lot of depth we should go. We need more time. I will tell observer that only. You give 1 hour class, 1.5 hour class for GL40, for medical also same time. This is up to advanced level, how we will complete, I will argue with him. Say the logic, sir, how it is able to. Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Five minutes, have patience, we can go ahead. So here, when there is no motion, when there is no external force tending to cause motion, what is force of static friction?
External force.
Okay. Now, when motion just begins, what is the force of static friction? That means I can say force of static friction can take any value within this, no? Understood this? Yes. I can say that it can have any value. Understood this? Clear? If Fs is 0, F external force is 0. Okay. If F is greater than 0 and less than mu s n, then there is no motion. We have F is equal to external force. Okay. If F is equal to mu s n, what will happen? Motion impedance. These are the three states we can have. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Shall I turn this? Hello? So if external force direction changes, automatically force of static friction will change direction. Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir.
One minute.
Finished?
Yes, sir.
Return this? Shall I turn this?
Yes, sir.
So you can say that force of static friction is understood this?
Yes.
Now we have understood this? It depends only upon the material.
Yes, sir.
Next. In the problem, they'll give this. You don't worry. Depend on the nature. Okay. Generally, mostly, you know this, no?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Any doubts are there till here, man?
No.
Till I go ahead, another 5 minutes. Still time is there, no? You know, till here you followed, no?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts are there?
No, sir.
Right, I will continue the next lesson. Okay? Take care. Yes. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye. Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir. Thank you.
Good morning to all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, sir. Yesterday we agreed upon that ionic bond is formed by a metal losing electron, a non-metal gaining electron. Metal can lose 1, 2, or 3 electrons. Non-metals may gain 1, 2, or 3 electrons. You get a positive ion from metal and a negative ion from non-metal, and that is the electrostatic attraction. The energy released when gaseous ions come together to give a crystal solid is called lattice energy. Lattice energy provides a driving force, all that we know. Whereas between non-metal atoms where electronegativity difference is less than 1.7, you have a covalent bond. In covalent bond, say two atoms, say like hydrogen, they share electron pair. One electron is given by one hydrogen, another electron is given by second hydrogen. The pair is actually shared by both fellows. Sometimes between oxygen atoms, so two electron pairs are shared. We that call it as a double bond.
Topic formal charge.
And between two nitrogen atoms, three electron pairs are shared. We call it as a triple bond. We represent by three. After the sharing of three electron pairs, each nitrogen is getting octet of electrons and happy. It means a covalent bond is formed in three different ways. Between two atoms, there can be a single bond, or there can be a double bond, or there can be a triple bond.
Morning, sir.
Therefore, the single bond, if you are looking at carbon, carbon can make a single bond with another carbon, or it can make a double bond, or it can make a triple bond. If there is a single bond, distance between carbon atoms appears to be 154 picometers. The distance, equilibrium distance between bonded atoms in a molecule is called bond length. The bond length in CC single bond is 154. If there is a C double bond C, it is 133 picometers. If there is a C triple bond C, it is 120 picometers. As the number of bonds between two atoms are increasing, bond length is becoming short. If you are looking at the bond lengths, that is the distance between two covalently bonded atoms, you can see a pattern. What pattern you see? Let us see. Let us try to see the pattern. We are looking at the pattern. Let us look at these values. Have you seen fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine are there in 17th group? FF single bond length is 144. CLCL single bond length is 199. BRBR single bond length is 228. II bond length is 267 picometers. It means down a group covalent bond length is increasing. As the size of the atoms are increasing. Also, if you look at HF, HCl, HBR, HI. The covalent bond is there between different atoms called heteroatomic molecules. Right. Even if you are looking FClBri as you are going down the group, the HX bond length 92, 127, 141, 160. Bond length increases down a group. Have you noticed? Also, you look at if there is a CC single bond, bond length is 154. If there is a CC double bond, bond length is 133. If there is a CC triple bond, bond length is 120. It means as the number of bonds are increasing between the atoms, bond length is decreasing. Bond length is a very important thing. We try to see the pattern. Okay, sir? Okay, sir? If two atoms are linked by a covalent bond, half of the distance between the bonded atoms is called covalent radius. So, sum of the covalent radius, for example, hydrogen covalent radius plus Cl covalent radius, if I add, I get HCl bond length. Sum of the covalent radii is equal to bond length if there is a single bond. Okay, sir? Bond length means distance between two bonded atoms. Down a group, bond lengths increase. As you are increasing the number of bonds between atoms, bond length decreases. Bond length idea is there only for covalent bond. Bond length is not there if there is an ionic bond, because ionic bond is only attraction, electrostatic attraction. Bond length term is relevant only for covalently bonded molecules. You know, covalent bond is there between non-metal atoms or atoms whose electronegativity difference is less than 1.7. You will be wondering, sir, what are the essential differences between ionic bond and covalent bond? What is the difference? Ionic bond is formed by somebody losing electron, somebody gaining electron, electron transfer. Covalent bond is formed by sharing a electron pair. No ions. Ionic bond always forms between a metal which loses electron and a non-metal that gains electron. Covalent bond can be formed between anybody, like non-metal atoms, only metal atoms, anybody whose electronegativity difference is less than 1.7. Whenever an ionic bond is formed, there is an electrostatic attraction between a positive ion and negative ion. There is no such electrostatic attraction in covalent compound. Ionic compounds at room temperature
Good morning, sir.
Mm-hmm.